Subscribe to our channel by clicking the subscribe button. Click the bell button and enjoy the latest uploads from our channel.
Plus, how you doing? iPhone 7 Plus, how are you doing today, Jet Black? And Inferno iPhone 8 Plus, what's going on, boy? So today we're going to talk about, you know, how these phones have held up in my experience over the duration of all of them, with the intentions of helping you decide which Plus device is for you. You know, I've done a video, I think, similar to this in the past, but here I want to give an updated experience on all of these. These were Apple's premier flagship phones until the iPhone 10 came along. And I know a lot of people are not digging these bezel game no more, but these phones are still for sale at Apple, and a lot of people are still going to buy these used when they drop even more in the department of, you know, cash, how much they're going to cost the person to purchase. So these phones aren't going anywhere for a long time, even though they got some of the chunkiest bezels known to mankind. Okay, so number one is design. Let's quickly brush over all of them. So they're all basically about the same dimensions and width and height. However, the iPhone 8 Plus is a little bit heavier than all of these at 202 grams, 192 on the 6S Plus, and 188 on the 7 Plus. So I really enjoyed the 7 Plus's lighter weight. It feels lighter than all of these phones. And for a bigger phone, you probably want slightly lighter because it's such a wide and big phone. Having heavy can sometimes be associated with premium feel. But to me, a large, huge phone that's heavy, that is just cumbersome to carry on a day-to-day. So the iPhone 7 Plus for me has been the best when it comes to the design area of weight. Okay, so talking about their build quality, when I first got the iPhone 6S Plus, I was like, yes, finally an iPhone that has, you know, a super premium build, because I came from a 5S. This one felt more like a MacBook, you know, the aluminum on the back was super sturdy. Then I went to the 7 Plus. I had the matte black edition. If you've been following the channel a long time, you would have known that I took that back, got the jet black edition, and this has been a nightmare when it comes to keeping it clean. It's got so many scratches. You're never going to see it here on camera because the camera, it's really hard to pick up these micro scratches, but there's a lot and definitely enough to annoy me. And I do think that if you're getting an iPhone 7 Plus, try to stay away from this jet black. No matter how pretty it looks on camera, it is a nightmare to take care of. And a lot of jet black users will go ahead and tell you the same thing that I'm telling you. Over here on the 8 Plus, the design on this, I always liked the glass feel, but the weight of it, I never really liked too much. Now, a lot of people disagree here. They say, well, it's premium feel. It's heavy. It feels premium. That's fine. But for me, when I'm going to be using a large phone, I want a comfortable, light design that still feels premium at the same time. And that's where the 188 grams was nice on the 7 Plus. So if you're looking for a lightweight, big phone, you want the 7 Plus out of all of these. If you're looking for a weighty, if you associate premium with super weighty, you want the 8 Plus here, definitely. This one goes to the top. Okay, so talking about displays, I don't want to go on too much because there's not much of a difference. All have 5.5 inch displays here, Retina Full HD, 401 pixels per inch on each. The iPhone 7 Plus gives you the wide color gamut P3, meaning the display was a little yellower, it was a little bit more natural for photography and things like that. Coming over to the iPhone 8 Plus, we did introduce ourselves to the True Tone display, which has been nice. It kind of automatically adjusts for a comfortable feel on the eye. Overall, it's just been a slight upgrade on each, and no matter which phone you go with, you're basically getting the same LCD display here. But if you want those extra little features, you're going to want to go up to the 8 Plus because it gives you the True Tone. I think that the 7 Plus and the 8 Plus display is closer than the 6S Plus. So if you want the best display here, consider one of these two right here, 7 Plus or 8 Plus. True Tone is not always necessary, so the 7 Plus could be that happy medium here when it comes to display. Okay, so let's talk quickly about the performance. Now, they're all going to be updated when it comes to the software. They're all running iOS 11, so we don't need to go on and on about that. I just want to share with you my performance experience with all of them. Now, the iPhone 6S Plus has been a great performer. There's really no issues with this phone when it comes to performance. Even in 2018, I'm not seeing a massive difference between the iPhone 7 Plus and the iPhone 8 Plus. Now, where this A11 CPU really does shine is when you're really beating on the phone. What I mean by that is really using it super heavy, like a ton of apps open and a ton of things going on in the background. That's where you'll really get that extra muscle from the A11 CPU. But on the day-to-day tasks, even all the way far back as the iPhone 6S Plus, there's really no issue. I mean, this thing can still burst really quick. It can open up games very easily, and everything just runs nicely on an iPhone 6S Plus. So speed going down the line here, 6S Plus to 7 Plus, really no issues at all on any of them. And even here at this point in 2018, I could recommend any of these when it comes to the performance round. But seeing as technology moves so fast in that your CPU might be outdated, you know, in a couple years, if you want a longer term phone, at least consider the A10 CPU in the iPhone 7 Plus. This could be, again, for the performance round, a happy medium with the 7 Plus. It's got a good value price point for that A10 CPU you're getting. Now, the A11, you know, if you want it, cool. I mean, but are you really going to notice a difference in performance between the 8 Plus and the 7 Plus? I haven't noticed really any in the stuff that I do. So performance is strong on all. Go with the 7 Plus if you want the best value to performance ratio at this point. Okay, guys, so I quickly want to discuss the cameras here on all devices. Now, in terms of hardware, single camera here on the 6S Plus versus the dual camera setups here, iPhone 7 Plus and the iPhone 8 Plus. That dual camera is a telephoto lens that gives you that shallow depth of field as well as that optical zoom, as you can see right here. It's not quite up to the standards of the new Huawei phones that can do up to 5x, but you can do 2x here, and that really helps you zoom in on things. So travelers who like to zoom on things, you're gonna want 7 Plus or 8 Plus, but all of these do shoot in the 4K mode. So if we do go into settings on all of them, you can see that they all shoot 4K 30. This one gives you 4K 60 and 4K 24 for that cinematic look. Now, when it comes to their slow motion abilities, let's go back here, slow motion abilities, you can see that the 6S Plus and the 7 Plus don't change, but you get 1080p at 240 here. So slow-mo is better on the iPhone 8 Plus. When it comes to their actual picture quality, however, they all shoot very similar photos in the daylight or in good lighting. So let me go ahead and demonstrate this really quickly. I'm going to shoot this photo of the 7 Plus. Let me not focus. It was doing a pretty good job by itself. Focus. Now let me focus here on the iPhone 7 Plus. Boom. And let me focus here on the iPhone 8 Plus. Boom. And you're going to see right here in these examples that all of these cameras' photos look about the same. And this is pretty much the case in most regards until you get into low lights. Let me zoom in a little bit so you can see these photos. The detail on every one of these cameras is almost identical. So I haven't really noticed too much of a difference when just shooting everyday photos, no matter which one you go with. Now, there's a little bit of, you know, sharper, shallow depth of field on the 8 Plus and down the line 7 Plus, and then you have a little bit less blur in the background. And that's probably the biggest difference when it comes to the cameras. The blur in the background, the zoom, and the low light photos make the 6S Plus not my recommendation here. The 7 Plus, again, does most of what the 8 Plus does in the camera, and it's really hard to tell any difference, if any difference at all, on the 8 Plus. So if you want video features, get yourself the 8 Plus. If you want a good medium between these two, the 7 Plus again. Okay, so let's quickly talk about the battery experience I've had on all of these. The 6S Plus has been the worst, even though it has the 2750 milliamp hour, 2691 milliamp hour on the 8 Plus, and 2900 milliamp hour. I'm getting through a full day easily on the 8 Plus. I'm getting almost like to the end of the day on the 7 Plus in my experience, about 9 o'clock p.m. from about, you know, 7 o'clock in the morning, the 7 Plus is done. The 8 Plus does about 20%. And the 6S Plus, unfortunately, hasn't been that great. I've been getting through most of the day, but that's probably because I have a bad battery in this phone. As you can see, I only have 86% maximum capacity, and I have a fuller capacity here on these two. But overall, I do think the 8 Plus is significantly better than these two on the battery life in the day-to-day. So, you know, when it comes to battery life, you want the 8 Plus here. On the whole, it also supports fast charging if you do get a charger and wireless charging, which these two don't support. Let's quickly go ahead and discuss the audio. So we do have the headphone jack here for the 6S Plus. That was nice. Overall, we do have the introduction of dual speakers here, stereo sound for the 7 Plus, which upped the decibel rating and made it louder than the 6S Plus significantly. So it's a much louder external phone than that phone. And then we update the decibel rating again for the iPhone 8 Plus with Bluetooth 5.0, which makes it connect to Bluetooth devices a lot faster than these two phones, which have Bluetooth 5.0, and it makes the connection more reliable. So I think overall the best audio experience here is the iPhone 8 Plus if you don't need the headphone jack. Of course, people are going to say, if I want a headphone jack, then you want the 6S Plus, but still it doesn't have as a reliable of a connection, and its external speakers are not as loud. So you're trading audio on the external for better, you know, internal audio and connection reliability for the 8 Plus. Okay, so where does that leave us? We pretty much covered everything. So let's take a look at Swappa here and take a look at the market value for a 6S Plus. So as of March 2018, these phones are going for about $300, $268. Some are selling on the low end. Depends on your gigabytes that you're going to get. The highest end, you're going for $338. So, you know, if you go to Apple, you're still going to pay significantly more for a 6S Plus. So I like to check these sources because this is what people on the street are actually selling them for. Let's go into iPhone 7 Plus and see where the value is on this one. So for a 32 gig, you're going, you know, $459 or $513 for a 128 gig. Now, keep in mind that at Apple, again, you're going to pay more. So I do think the iPhone 7 Plus is definitely worth $450 if you can find one, or even $500. It's still a really good phone, and it's going to last a long time, as the new iPad just came out with the same processor in the A10. Now, the 8 Plus here, market value, is still right around where it launched at $688 for the 64 and $791 for the 256. But remember, at Apple, $799 for a 64 gig, and then you got 256 gig at almost $1,000 for the iPhone 8 Plus. So yes, these phones are used on Swap, but they're not brand new. But at the same time, if you get a slightly used or a phone that was only used for a week, you're basically gonna pay $200 less, which is a pretty good deal. Anyway, that's it. Are you going with any of these? Do you have any of these? Do you plan on keeping any of your Plus models for a long time? Or are you just